Hello and welcome to JoCo Cruise 2016. You've heard Shake It Off probably 4 or 5 times in a row. It's actually a reference to an earlier cruise. We're starting the new monkey orientation by feeding you an in-joke that you don't get. Exactly what you feared was going to happen. There will now be a quiz. Anyone who gets 7 or fewer less, or fewer correct on this quiz, must leave the boat. Listen, think of it this way, the worst has already happened and we're all still here, so it's fine. Guys, thank you so much for being here. I have a question, how many of you are not actually first time sea monkeys? You're just like asking questions, and you're just really into orienting. I want to get super oriented this year. Last year I got partially oriented, this year, all the way.
How many people are already completely overwhelmed? Oh my god, what did I get myself into?
Perfect! Perfect. First things first. This is Paul, by the way.
Oh, hi,
I'm Paul. And that's Storm. And this is Jonathan. I'm Jonathan. We're three out of the 4 people who kind of run this thing. The 4th, Drew Scarface, should be down here shortly to come say hello to all of you and decide which of you he is going to kill and where they're staying. It's to keep Poseidon happy. First things first, if you have not gone through registration yet, has anybody not gone through registration? Have you all got your badges and gone through registration?
Wow.
If you have not done so, go do that now. This is your ticket to all the JoCo Cruise events. Please make sure you have it with you and worn on your person. If you misplace your badge, find a helper monkey. Do we have the helper monkey? Helper monkeys in the back? Okay. Can you sort of hold it? Are the helper monkeys, do you have your special helper monkey lanyards? Well, that's no use, is it? The helper monkeys have some very brightly colored lanyards for their badges when they are on duty that say helper monkey on them.
What color is it, Paul?
Yellow.
Bright?
Yellow. Not sure where that is on the spectrum.
And any one of them, if you have any questions at all, they're a great place to start. If they cannot answer your question for you, they will find a person who can.
There's also an info desk that is staffed by helper monkeys that is outside of the game room, which is where registration was today. It turns into a game room. Did we mention that?
Ladies and gentlemen, the 4th pillar of stone, Drew Scarface Westfall. We only have 3 mics, though. We weren't sure if you're actually going to make it. I'm here. You all should have gotten this in your cool swag bag. How about this year's giveaway, huh? It is utterly impractical, and we were so excited when we thought of it. Let's give everyone a bulky plush thing
that probably won't look very good after being dunked in water.
Yeah. Drew and our office manager, Anna, along with a couple other very hardworking people, basically put together literally over a ton of 12 pallets worth of all the crap that you have received and will receive on board. So please give a long review.
About customs laws and procedures that are just bring to your head, Drew is your guy.
Do you happen to think it's fascinating and you want to talk about it for like 45 minutes, an hour?
Like inventory, palletizing.
Oh my god.
Yeah. Oh my god, warehouses.
Yes.
How do we stem the confusion?
How do we stem the confusion? You start with this right here, the Sea Monkey newsletter. This is your introductory newsletter that answers many, many, many of the questions you might have. Among other things,
on page something, well, first of all, in the middle,
it's got a map of most of the ship, and on the following page, highlighting basically all the areas that we use for any of our events, it is handy. It's in our hands. And then just beyond that, there is this grid, which breaks down all of the major events happening. Anything that's in green, all of the main events, those are basically things that everyone theoretically is going to be at. We won't schedule other events to conflict with any events. Basically, the big concerts that will be happening in here and in Studio B, which is on Deck 3. There's also various featured events, which are sort of panels and side performances and office hours by our various performers. We also have a writing track and a gaming track. You don't have to pick one or the other, but we just have, first of all, Keith Baker and Jen Ellis. Yeah, I'm good with names. Are Keith and Jen, are you here by any chance? Keith Baker and Jen Ellis have helped coordinate, this is the second year, they're helping coordinate our gaming tracks, so give a hand to them. And authors John Scalzi and Pat Rothfuss are sort of coordinating and curating our writing track events. They're all over here. Also, one of our favorite parts of the cruise is the Shadow Cruise events, which is what you all coordinate and curate. Basically, we make a bunch of different spaces available, and you can schedule whatever the heck you feel like doing if you think other people would be interested in it. They're not listed in this grid. They are available in several places. There is the online schedule, which we should have emailed to all of you at the sketch page. If you have internet on the ship, you can find that there. Also, is anybody not familiar with when we say the term Cruise Monkey and Twitt-arr? These are apps voluntarily developed by several of our passengers over the past few years. Cruise Monkey, among many other things. Where's our Cruise Monkey developers? Any of them here? They're busy making sure it's working in the room, I think. It is downloadable while you're still here in port. It's available for iOS and Android. You can download it from either of their app stores. It's just called Cruise Monkey, one word. Among many other things, it contains a version of the schedule that you can get without having to connect to the Wi-Fi, to the ship's Wi-Fi, just to the ship's internet. And then Twitt-arr is a, how would you describe it, Drew?
Service very similar to Twitter.
Hence the crappy pun.
You can send sports, you can check your C-mail. It's just like the internet you've come to know and love.
I didn't approve any of this, by the way.
A note about the internet, if you are going to take a special Wi-Fi package rate, you need to, I've been informed, purchase that today in order for it to be charged to your room correct.
We will also be sending around, except for tonight, an updated version of the schedule, a daily version of the Sea Monkey Guide, because things just evolve as the week goes along, and it will include the Shadow Cruise events as well as the main, the gaming, and the writing events.
And Cruise Monkey will be updated with any changes and additions we make to the schedule during the week. We'll make those on the online schedule, and those changes will get pushed to Cruise Monkey so that you don't have to connect to the internet to get the latest version.
So in other words, Twitter and Cruise Monkey can be used without purchasing the internet package, because those things are all happening over the internet. And there are the configuration instructions for those inside your Sea Monkey package. That package. Newsletter?
Glossy.
Yeah, the glossy thing.
We're just going to go over a couple more things, and then we want to open up to any questions that you have. Dinner. We are all in the 5:30 dinner seating every night in the main dining room, which is the rear of the ship. It's a three-floor dining room. We have the entirety of the third floor, or the bottom floor, which is Deck 3, and then a good portion of the second floor, Deck 4, the tables are mostly clustered around the open area. You'll see it when you get in there. Any of our tables are marked with white table tents called for open seating. You are not to ignore what your seat pass says for a table number. You can sit at any of the tables with a white table tent on them. It's just like the high school cafeteria and just as stressful, except no bullies in this cafeteria. You are welcome to sit at any of those tables. You can switch around night after night. There are some tables marked with red table tents. Those are people who have requested fixed seating. They'll be sitting at those tables every night. You just can't sit in the... Go ahead, question? Table tent is a little folded piece of paper. Looks nice like a tent.
Well, like a tent.
Yeah.
Ours stand up on the tables.
So. Yeah. There you go. You'll find a very tiny Boy Scout inside. If at any point during the week you decide that you would like to switch to fixed seating, and then you and the people you're at the table you're with decide we want to have this table for the rest of the week, you can let a helper monkey know and let them know. You'll give them your names and your cabin numbers, and we'll make sure that the dining room knows to assign that table to you. If there's any questions or problems, we'll make sure we'll get it fixed for you. All my notes are in my laptop, which is side stage. We don't have notes on this.
You want to go get it?
Yes, I do. Here, Riff.
I'm just going to vamp a little while. I will say, just a note about conventions and social functions in general. I can't stand them. I hate to be in a big crowd of people that I don't know. I understand that for many of us it's especially hard because some of us don't ever leave our houses ever except to come on this cruise. But I will say that the bunch of people that you are hanging out with on this cruise ship is the nicest, most welcoming group of people you will ever meet. And it's not just me saying that, all of our performers every year who are new come away saying that is the nicest audience and the nicest bunch of people I've ever met. So if you're feeling shy and lonely, just go up to somebody and talk to them, and they will be your friend. I guarantee.
And this year, we even have, you may have seen it in your welcome packets, the Sea Monkey Activity Book that was put together by Lone Shark Games, and hold one up there. It's a little book. It was designed so that you don't have to do anything with it, but it's some really low pressure ways to just, you know, go up and talk to people if you want, and give you a thing to do, and there are prizes for doing so. But we'll talk about that a little bit more at the welcome reception.
And Jonathan was saying, you know, I don't think anyone on this stage actually likes big crowded social functions. We understand it can be very overwhelming, especially, you know, 6 years in. We know there's a lot of inside references going back and forth from people who've been on it before. We know it can be a little daunting if you're new. We promise you, everyone on this trip is really open and welcoming and friendly, and they want everyone else to have a good time. We heartily encourage you to just take whatever steps to just make that first introductory step. If someone's playing a game that you're interested in, hang by and watch, ask some questions, ask if you can join in. Everybody's really, really great. It's a little scary, actually.
Maybe this year's big meme will be yours.
No prizes awarded to whoever gets this year's big meme.
No pressure.
The only thing that we actually haven't mentioned that is in my notes is just a reminder of the 24/7 game room, which is where you went through registration.
Sponsored by Steve Action Games.
Down there on two, during dinner tonight, that is going to get reconfigured. One whole half of it will just be a bunch of four top tables, and there will be a whole games library in there where you just want to play a game, take it, play it, treat it like it was your own, and then put it away when you're done. There is also some spillover gaming space during the sea days and the morning that we are in St. Thomas in the main dining room. On decks 4 and 5, we have some events going on in there, but they may not necessarily take up the whole side of the ship. Also, especially if anyone's interested in some role-playing games that might take a little longer, you don't want to take up a table in the game room for quite so long if you feel guilty about that for some reason. We have a whole space, deck 5, port side, all the way in the back corner, because we know you guys like dark corners when you're playing your role-playing games. We sort of designated that sort of an unofficial RPG area. You're welcome to use that. You're welcome to game anywhere else as well, but if you want sort of a dedicated, slightly quieter space, because the game room can, during peak times like after dinner and such, can get a little crowded and noisy. There are other options. And you can game wherever you find space on the ship. Plunk down, play a game. Would not be surprised if some of the non-JoCo people may be interested and want to know what's going on as well.
We warned the crew that there will be games everywhere. That's at the game room itself is for the JoCo Cruise group. So, you know, if you meet someone who is, you know, whomever, those spaces are exclusive to us.
Only just because there's limited availability, and we don't want, you know, people who've paid for the privilege to be part of our group to not have space to get in. But if you want a game with a non-JoCo person anywhere else on the ship, please, we heartily encourage it, because more of us equals better of us, right? Something like that. Otherwise, thank you so much for coming and doing this. We cannot wait to put on a great cruise for you. And at this point, if anyone has any questions at all, there are no dumb questions. Just ones you'll need to shout louder if we can't hear you.
Although, if it's something that's a longer explanation that's already in the Sea Monkey guide, we'll say that.
We may point you at that. This was the first hand I saw over here.
Where can
you find a hole punch? I believe the deck 5, the guest registration, and the info, the ship's the front desk, so to speak.
All the way on the right.
All the way on the right.
Wow.
Which way are you? Starboard?
You're right. Starboard, we call it. Starboard.
All the way on the right.
Yes. Right down front.
Is that a satellite phone on your head? No, this is not a satellite phone. This is a ship phone. There's a small cell tower on board.
Only special people can have them. Which is why Drew is the only one on the stage right now. Oh, Storm's got his.
Very kids. The best technology that 1992 could offer.
I got mine
in
there too. Thanks, Brett.
For potentially popular events, do you recommend arriving early? And if so, how early?
For potentially popular events, do you recommend arriving early?
Well, it depends. People usually tend to, if you want to sit at the front, yeah, but otherwise, the venue, it's pretty quick to get in. Just always make sure you bring your badge, because we do have people who are going to be checking them. But apart from that, you don't have to arrive particularly early.
Well, for the main theater and Studio B, there's room for everyone, and there's no bad seats for these events. If you're talking about like a side stage event, we are hoping and expect, it's always a little bit of a guessing game. So to date, we've had very few events ever run out of available space. If you want to be sure to get into a particular thing, half an hour early, maybe? But so now that I've said that, you guys get there 45 minutes early and really knock this guy out.
There are usually beverages available wherever you are waiting, so it's a pleasant experience. Another question?
Okay.
The question is, are there any sort of book signing events with some of the authors we have on board?
We don't have any officially scheduled autograph sessions on board, only because we didn't want to turn this event into sort of a everybody stand in line for 6 hours for 20 seconds with your favorite person. That said, if an author is giving a reading, after the reading, they fully expect and will be fine with if you wanted to bring a book to that event. Jonathan, if you wanted to say a word or two about autographs in general.
Yeah, the philosophy behind it is, you know, we've attended cons and we've been part of cons. And in our experience as the person on the other side of the table, it's very hard to actually have any sort of meaningful interaction at the head of an autograph line or a photo line or anything like that. So we don't structure those events because we don't really like them. And keep in mind, you're going to be here for an entire week. We're going to be together all week long. And so your first sighting of famous person X that you're excited to see, you're going to be terrified and amazed. By day four, you're going to be like, hey, dude, in the windjammer. As, you know, you're getting yet another plate of overcooked gluten-free pasta. And so what I mean, by all means, if you want to get somebody's autograph, go, you know, as Paul said, you know, go to one of their events and meet up with them afterwards or catch them in the hallway. Try to be a little bit aware of the dividing line between public time and private time. If famous person X is hanging out with their family by the pool, that might not be a good time to approach them for an autograph
or asleep in their own cabin.
But, you know, if they're out at a function or an event, that's probably the kind of approach. But in general, I would encourage you to think of this as an experience where we are all hanging out together, and the more, I find that this is true, the more you are able to sort of relax and just be among this large group of people, the more you will have a more valuable experience than you would if you waited in line, got to the front of it, had your 15 seconds to talk to your favorite famous person. So that's the philosophy behind that.
But that said, if there is an author who is a favorite of yours and you have a book and you would like to get it signed, if they're doing a reading or after a panel that they're doing, they understand that, and that's a great time to do it. It should not be a problem.
And here's some advice. When you're meeting a famous person that you want to meet, go, here's a great way to start. Hi, my name's Jonathan. You put your own name in
there. No, yeah.
But that's a perfect way to start. Everybody relaxes. You're just two people talking. Produces a fun and easy conversation rather than like coming up with a thing to sign. Then you've already set up a weird, it's a different dynamic, which is less fun.
I picked someone over here. Yes.
Dinner time. The center says 6. The front says 5:45, and my card says 5:30.
I like to keep you guessing.
Where, that might be another typo in the book. Where does it say 6?
In the center
map. All right, we screwed. That's typo 2.
You may notice also the schedule says January.
Please ignore the entire schedule.
Just the details in it.
The dates are correct, it's just it's not January.
And the colors are pretty. But no.
So also we're not looking for Fort Lauderdale, that's the other
number two. Did we mention we're going to Mars?
I never mentioned it because we're not doing that. But that is a good catch that you pointed out. Dinner is 5:30 every night, except for tonight, because we wanted to get a full hour of our cocktail reception, which starts at 4:45. That goes to 5:45, and then you can immediately go to dinner after that. Every other night, dinner starts at 5:30. And they're not militant about it if you show up 5:10. It's like they're not going to turn you away or anything like that.
Maybe we should preemptively talk about formal night.
Oh, yes, there are two formal nights. In the main dining room, those are tomorrow night and Friday night. And the guidelines for that, according to the cruise ship, is for gentlemen, jacket and tie, and for ladies...
Nothing else?
Yeah.
Anything else is forbidden.
You can wear the tie wherever you want to wear it.
And this is not my joke, but for ladies, it is whatever it is you wear that gets you into formal events. Hey, I'm only a messenger. On those two nights in the main dining room, they do request that. Only in the main dining room, so if you do not bring formal wear, you can just eat somewhere else that night and go anywhere else on the ship. The other nights, in the main dining room, they describe the appropriate wear as smart casual. Generally, in practice...
We got the smart covered, I think.
In practice, that means usually no bathing suits. They prefer you not wear shorts, no like muscle shirts, because I know you guys are all about the Ed Hardy in this one. And like flip-flops. Like basically, don't walk in sopping wet having just gotten out of the pool. And you should be fine, especially today, as a lot of people may not have gotten their baggage in time for dinner delivered to their cabin, so they're pretty lenient the first night especially. That said, I think I've said it somewhere, if not in the book there, the general guideline we have found works is if you at least look like you're making an effort, that generally they'll be pretty good. And we've made them aware of your proclivities, especially as far as what constitutes formal wear. Such as, I don't know, a full-on Klingon dress uniform.
That said, we do need to, whatever the ship's rules are in these things, we abide, but they have been informed.
This is only semi-related to that, but another thing that we cannot stress enough, wash your hands. It sounds kind of silly, but we are all basically in a very large petri dish with food on it.
Yeah, right? I wish you hadn't said that. Why'd you have to put food on it? That makes it extra gross.
What about gin? Gin. Yeah,
from a very large nerd-filled petri dish. How's that?
That's worse than food.
The alcohol will totally sterilize you.
Any other questions that haven't come up right here in the center?
The magical special internet, if you connect to the ship's Wi-Fi on your device, it should bring up a window prompting you to pay for either...
Just like if you're in a hotel, yeah. Bring up a screen where you can sign up for it.
And it may not say it on the screen. The special price that we get if you purchase for the week, I believe, is $129.95 or $129.99. It's basically $10 off compared to if you were paying for each individual day.
And it's two devices, unlimited internet.
Is it two or is it one?
I
think it's one, yeah.
Oh, one, sorry, it's one device.
Don't listen to details, guy. He's just a figurehead.
I don't know, I just play music about monkeys.
Don't have arms?
And that should get automatically applied to your cabin when you make that purchase. You can keep an eye. I believe you can check your balance. Can you do that on your TV?
Yeah.
Or you can go down to the front desk and ask request what your current balance is. If there's any questions, they can sort that out for you.
Television is a technology that was developed in the 20th century.
It's like a fat dumb iPad.
Question right there.
How many sea monkeys are there?
About 1,100.
We don't know because none of us can actually count.
We really should start keeping track of it.
Yeah, you don't know anything about it.
That's over here.
Does the time change while we're aboard?
Yes.
Oh, I can address this question for you. Sort of. We have confirmed and reconfirmed because we do cross over into the Atlantic time zone partway through this trip. The ship itself will stay constantly on Eastern time, so ship time. Eastern time, it never changes. And all of the JoCo events take place on ship time, and also our arrival and departure times are ship time. But when we are in St. Thomas and St. Martin, the islands themselves are actually on Atlantic, and they're an hour ahead.
Which is actually kind of fine, because if you are 1 hour off, you'll just arrive at the ship 1 hour earlier. And that's actually another good thing to bring up. Very seriously, make sure you are back to the ship, because it is out of there at the appointed time. Look up Gavin Verheyen Volcano. It was good. Did I answer your question? Awesome.
That brings me to the topic of shore excursions, very briefly. If you have signed up for a shore excursion online prior to the cruise, your tickets for that excursion should be delivered to your cabin the day prior, possibly the afternoon or evening prior. If you want, you can always check with the shore excursion desk just to make sure you're all set. There are still shore excursions available. Unfortunately, because of the logistics of it, you aren't able to book any of the JoCo exclusive excursions anymore. But if there's a particular thing you want to participate in, there are departure times for most of the shore excursions still available. They just will be with the regular people.
In the back section there.
Who are you talking about setting up a shadow event? There should be at the info desk, which is outside of the conference center down on 2, I do believe they have forms that you can fill out. Basically describing your events. If you can, I believe you're allowed to request a certain space or type of space. Again, ask Gavin.
And do ask Gavin if you see
this. This is one fascinating story.
This
gentleman
has a question
over here.
For those of us not connected, there
will
be an updated list of shadow events and
Shadow
Events that are.
Yes.
If you're not connected, how do you get the updated list of events?
Yeah, if you're not online or connected, we will be listing all the shadow events and any schedule changes on the 2 screens that are outside the conference center will be updated as far as when we have to submit those each day.
Also, the daily version of the Sea Monkey we'll be delivering to all of our staterooms will have an update. So that'll be arriving, I think, around midnight or 1 each night, except for tonight, because there's so much going on.
And those will have a list of the next day's events. each day. And also in general, this is something we haven't mentioned, the game room, sponsored by Steve Jackson. Actually, it's an info hub as well, and there are whiteboards and materials for, like every year, stuff just appears. Like really, if you want a physical place to check what's happening, it's really awesome. A lot of people use this cruise as an opportunity to actually kind of turn off the internet and their phones for a week, and it is, while really scary, actually very refreshing. And we recommend you give it a try if you're so inclined. That said, we should also mention St. Thomas is a U.S. Virgin Islands port, and most major telecom carriers, you have standard U.S. connectability for cell and data. Your mileage may vary according to your carrier, but I know for a fact, for example, AT&T and Verizon, you can turn your phone back on. So if you really need to check your messages, you can do that there without having to worry about paying for internet. And also, if you don't want to pay for ship internet in St. Thomas and St. Martin, there are plenty of restaurants and places like that that will offer free Wi-Fi, usually if you're there to get to order something. But and again, your mileage may vary as far as the speed of that, but there is, you can find ways to connect without having to pay for the ship's internet if you do not wish to.
Free internet with every order of conch fritters.
For those people who signed up for the food tour on St. Martin that I organized, there's 60 people going in 4 groups. If there's any uncertainty about what group you're in or what time you're going in, please let me know.
Is that, you said you changed the time from 9:30 to 10:30. Is that ship time or St. Martin?
Does anyone else have a question about the general operations of the cruise?
Okay, well,
everybody's pointing over here.
Yeah, I was wondering how tabletop cake stands
was
going to work
when signing up and like. Yes, that is a good question, isn't it?
A question we will be answering later. The question was about the tabletop taste test. There will be a sheet down at the information desk outside the game room. Sponsored by Steve Jackson. Where you'll be able to sign up for a particular hour.
It'll be divided into 3 separate hour sections. You can choose which hour you want to take part in.
What?
When is it, or when will the sign-ups be done?
Well, let's see. It'll be later.
Soon!
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 T-M.
We'll get an answer to that question. We will let you know during the welcome reception, which is happening at 4:45 in Studio B. How's that?
Yeah, I just don't know exactly what the info desk hour is yet, but we'll be publishing that.
We just want to make sure, we want to give you an answer that's correct. We want to make sure it's there.
I'm sorry, did you hear that?
If you sign up for a particular hour, do you show up at that hour at the game room?
It'll actually be, you'll be given a card that tells you what time and where to go.
If we're not signing up for internet, how do we connect to the Cruise Monkey server?
There are instructions in your Sea Monkey newsletter. There's a URL that you can go to. You have to download Cruise Monkey onto your device before you leave. But then there's a URL that you can go to connect using the ship's
Wi-Fi.
Yeah, that will direct you to Twitter and Steve.
And the schedule will be updated and pushed to the Cruise Monkey app as the week goes along.
Yes.
So.
And you don't actually even need Cruise Monkey to view just Twitter.
That's
can
true.
You Twitter in your browser at that same URL, which you'll find in the Sea Monkey, which is jcc6.rccl.com.
I see a burning question in the back. Gratuities are included, yes.
Does that also apply to drink packages?
No.
If you want to tip, there are gratuities included every time you buy a drink on the ship. If you'd like to tip extra, you can do so on your receipt. That has nothing to do with the prepaid gratuities, which are for your stateroom attendant and your dining room people, although you can also name them on the envelope and tip that extra as well.
Thanks.
All right.
So that one first thing. It is possible if you, the ship itself does have cellular service that is mad expensive, And if you are not careful to turn your phone into airplane mode or at least turn off roaming data, you could accidentally, you know, if you just start receiving some incoming text, you got
yes.
in a picture.
Yes, do that.
Yeah.
Put it in
so,
airplane mode.
Yeah, it is a very good idea to go into airplane mode or at least turn off roaming data.
There's a question down here.
A certain song that people apply makeup for.
Question is, can one apply makeup situationally?
Yes. Yeah, are you speaking of perhaps zombie makeup? Yeah, that's fine.
They have asked us to ask you not to wear like full face masks, but makeup is not a mask.
Maybe not for you.
Anyone else?
Blue shirt.
Yes.
You downloaded the Sea Monkey app.
Sorry, right here. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
I'm
sorry.
Yes, I also
have
Oh, if you downloaded it and it's not working, where should you go to fix it?
It's not working right now.
They're setting up the server
right now.
Right
now it's not working because they're currently still setting up the server.
I believe we had intermittent service, so some of you may have been able to connect, some of you may have not. Give it until this evening.
You know, we'll keep you posted. We'll be on the stage a lot, and we'll tell you what's going on when you can.
So amazingly enough, a cruise ship is not built to have an incredibly robust Wi-Fi and internet situation. Seeing as the average age of most cruisers is 87.
That's actually one of the other huge information channels we have that we forgot about. We do warning announcements, time of day varies. But if there are major things like that that we need to update, if you come to that day's main events, we'll be doing those announcements. Question?
Can I request you to play one of your songs even though it's out of season?
Can you request me to play a song that is out of season?
To be fair, you
a lot of feelings happening.
To be fair, you are in autumn.
I am in autumn. Are you thinking of a Christmas song, or you are? Which Christmas song are you thinking of? Kind of made a front. Right. I will take that under advisement.
If he does not play that song, he will play a song that has many of the same notes in it.
Any more questions?
Beckman. Oh, yeah, you. If for any reason you need to cancel an excursion, whether injury or just don't feel like it, you can do that without any penalty up to 24 hours prior to that excursion. In the particular case you're describing where you're injured but you want to swap it for another JoCo excursion, I would talk directly to the shore excursion desk. Again, the logistics are a little weird how those are set up. You can try. I can't promise you that they will let you do that, but they will do it if they can, and if there is space available. So I hope so. I'm rooting for you. Also, sorry about your injury, or his injury.
How much time, more time do we have for questions?
We've got about 15
oh,
minutes.
Okay. Who has a long-winded question?
Disconnected from the internet and moving from where it was to where it is, which is here now.
And for the people who were being able to post, we would, I'd say ghosts are responsible.
Yeah. Internet ghosts.
Poseidon was not pleased.
No. It should not have been working yet, and it still is not working. Okay. It will be as soon as the server is set up and up and
running. Alright, looking for puzzle faces. Here.
Are there any of the main shows that will be interpretive? And if not, where can you get a copy of
This is an interesting question.
This is a fantastic
question.
Many
of the main shows are going to be interpreted, which there actually is not any current plans.
We do not currently have any plans to do so. That would be a nice thing for us to do. I'm sorry. We didn't think of it before.
You can find Jonathan's lyrics on Jonathan's site. You can find Paul and Storm lyrics on paulandstorm.com. That's two shows out of the way. Yeah. Yes. But
no, honestly, we don't have any capacity to do that, but I think that's a fantastic idea. Yeah.
Right behind you, you have questions, Bob?
We'll come back to you. Anyone else confused besides me?
Ready for that.
The question is, if you don't want to go on a formal excursion, but you might like to find some monkeys to gather who just want to go amble around town or something, we don't have a specific place to do that.
Well, I would recommend, again, if you go to the game room sponsored by Steve Jackson Games, that you can write, hey, I want to go to, X Beach. And X Beach is awesome, by the way. And most of the time, you'll probably find some people interested. If you are, if you do want to use Twitter, you can post on there and say, hey, I'm thinking about going to Y Beach.
I would even suggest, to simplify things, I would say anyone who wants to do this thing, pick a place and say, meet at this place at this time, and whoever's there by that time, let's all go do this thing. And that way you don't have to do a bunch of coordination. Take command. It's your personal excursion.
Yes, sir.
Is there some specific time for us to check in all of our games in the game room? And how does that process work?
The question is there a specific time to check in your personal games in the game room? We don't have an official sort of library system per se. The game room is being going to get reconfigured while we are all at dinner and reset for gaming. And they will set up basically a number of long tables along one of the long walls that people usually just sort of put their games on. It is a good idea to label your game with your name, phone number, address, just in case there's any error. It's so far really genuinely just been on the honor system, and we've had no problems that have at least come back to me.
I think it's because we're on mostly closed environments, that it's been that way. But that is something that we are going to be working on in the future.
Oh, you remembered your question? All right.
At what point do you worry? Huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention for an important announcement?
Jesus.
In 30 minutes at 4 p.m., the ship will conduct a mandatory assembly drill for all guests. The emergency signal will be sounded. It consists of 7 short blasts followed by 1 blast on the ship's whistle and internal alarm system. This drill is required by international law, and all guests must attend whether you cruise before or not. Please note that life jackets are not required to be worn at this drill. Safety information and instructions are posted in your stateroom, and you'll also find your assembly station number in large print on the right side of your CPAS card. Each guest must have their CPAS card in hand and available for the crew members who will be guiding you to your assembly station. As you make your way to your assembly station, please note the evacuation signs along your route and any alternative escape routes. If you're traveling with small children, please contact your stateroom attendant who will provide a child or infant-sized life jacket for you. Another announcement will be made 15 minutes prior to the drill, and at that time, all guest service facilities will be closed in preparation for the drill and will not reopen until the captain has dismissed you from your stations. This is also the first call for all persons not sailing with the Freedom today to please proceed ashore using the gangway located on deck number 4. Message to all crew involved in today's guest assembly drill, please leave your stations by 3:40 p.m. Thank you again for your attention and cooperation. Once again, the drill will commence at 4 p.m.
And we're back. The question was, at what point should you worry if your bags have not arrived? I would say if after you get back to your room from dinner, your bags are still not there, you might want to call down to the front desk to inquire about their status. If the, usually the case is if someone, if they found something that they need to check on in your bag, that they think it might be contraband or something, or they want, they think you might be bringing liquor with you, or if you accidentally put a bottle of liquor in your bag.
For sure, all accidental.
Yeah, it's all accidental. They will contact you, and you'll have to go down and check your bag with them. And if, for example, if it's a bottle of liquor, they will just hold it for you down there until the end of the cruise. They won't smash it over your head or pitch it into the sea.
Or drink it themselves.
But yeah, I would not worry. I would not start to worry until after dinner.
One year, I checked my guitar, and then I almost didn't have my guitar for my own show. Because I'm not very smart.
Another question.
Alcohol.
Alcohol
is the problem.
Question.
Can you define the meaning of fancy as
in
fancy pants?
Mm.
I think if you look in your heart, you will know what fancy pants
mean. Towards the back of the front section.
Yes.
That's you. Go ahead. Yeah. Yeah. No, not behind you.
It's you. That is just a chair.
You will hear more about that at the welcome reception.
Okay.
I will only say that a monarch has been selected.
Right here.
First of all, musical instruments for kazoos.
So that is entirely correct.
The question is, if you have musical instruments or want to do a performance, are there limitations on the ship? It's kind of the, you know, they don't want there to be a block in area, that sort of thing. But certainly if you want, I know there are some people who are doing song circles and things like that, or if you wanted to hold a shadow event, you can go to the info desk and set up.
I would generally be wary of doing it in public spaces, which is not to say you can't do it at all, but if you are sort of inflicting your music on others who may not want to hear it, you maybe find someplace a little more private.
No offense.
No offense. I'm sure you're wonderful.
No, but in general, do keep in mind that the, you know, the other two-thirds of the ship is filled with people who have no intention of...
of robot monkey.
They don't know what a JoCo is. So they're just here to have a regular cruise. So, you know, when you are out in public spaces and in public events, you know, be cool, be nice, be cordial, the ship is in charge of stuff, so if somebody, if ship staff says, you know, you can't do this here, please listen to what they say. And don't say, do you know who I am? That never works. Yes, sir.
Your best four-sentence line for explaining to an 87-year-old who these 11 people are and what they're doing.
Oh, yeah. Can I make a pitch for what is a JoCo?
Yeah.
You may get asked by a normal. What is the look at your badge and say, what is a JoCo cruise? And how can I a JoCo cruise?
This is a great question, and our lack of easy answer shows you how bad we are at marketing. I wish that was a joke.
We have the only marketing tagline that has four footnotes.
I don't know. I mean, it's hard. It's very hard for us to describe this event. I mean, you know, I think to an 87-year-old cruiser, probably the easiest thing to say is JoCo is Jonathan Coulton, and he's a musician. And it's a bunch of music and comedy and entertainment.
And nerds.
And then they'll say, why is your hair all colors?
Or they will say, my grandson uses the internet.
Are you scientists?
Yes, it's surprising. And nerds are scientists. Yes, not a joke.
Just describe to them your job.
Yes.
Forgive me if you've answered this already, but I noticed that the Shadow Cruise events are not in here. Where are they?
The Shadow Cruise events, for anyone who came in late, the Shadow Cruise events will be listed in several places. They will be updated daily for the current day on the two screens outside the conference center. We will list all of the next day's Shadow Cruise events in the nightly Sea Monkey newsletter that you'll receive every night except for tonight. They will also appear on the online schedule and on the schedule that's available on Cruise Monkey and Twitt-arr.
Which do not require to pay for the internet.
Except for the one that's online for the foot in the middle there.
Oh, online.
Been doing this for 6 years. Does it show?
Still not clear.
More questions?
Any at all?
Right in the center.
This is a very good question. Where can you go that food is free, and where can you get other food that you must pay for? Dinner in the main dining room is always free. Dinner in the Windjammer, or any meal in the Windjammer is always free.
There's on the promenade, there's pizza that is 24 hours that is free.
Legendary pizza that magically starts tasting way better after 1:47 a.m.
It is barely pizza.
On the other end of the promenade, there's also like a little cafe where they'll have like sandwiches and stuff that are free, breakfast stuff that's free. The Starbucks coffee is not free, but it's the same place. There are
also several upmarket. Yeah, there's as well that you can pay for Ben and Jerry's. There's a cupcake place on the promenade. There are also several restaurants, smaller restaurants on the ship that you can pay an upcharge to eat at. There's Chops Grill, which is a steakhouse. There is Giovanni's,
yes,
which is an Italian restaurant. There's also brand new this year, Sabourin, which is named after me apparently, because you can usually find Sabourin in Sabourin. You know, it's a joke and also the truth. Get you both ways. That's a Mexican restaurant. They have a guacamole station right there at your table.
But you're way
so good.
You're way more likely to run into free food on the ship.
Yeah, most of it is free. There's also breakfast and lunch in the dining room, which is a nice option. And, room service.
Except after, I think, midnight. There is a charge, just a I don't remember if it's $5 or $10 or $15 a delivery fee.
I tell you, there's nothing like getting a stack of cheapers at 11:30 at night for free.
Other questions? Oh, and also there's a soft serve ice cream machine up on the ladder. Serve yourself.
It's called sprinkles, but there are no sprinkles. It's sprinkles.
The sprinkles are in your heart.
question in the center.
By the pre-purchase what?
The merchant JoCo Cruise Home Office.
I think those are being, they should be delivered by the end of dinner, right?
Yeah.
Drew is the one who really knows the details of that. Most of you should have gotten them, but if you haven't received them after dinner, let a helper monkey know and give them your room number and name, and they'll filter it through to the appropriate people to make sure it gets there. Just so you know, in case you don't have it handy, the remaining schedule for the day is, as you've heard over the announcement, 4 o'clock is the safety drill, mandatory for everyone. It's very easy. You don't even have to put your life jacket on. You just have to stand around. Half of us will have to stand around in the sun, whichever side of the ship they make you do, but it's only like 10 minutes. It's very easy. 4:45, Studio B on Deck 3 is the welcome cocktail reception. You will meet all of your performers there and then. It is an hour of free drinks and meeting all of your fellow sea monkeys. It is going to be a little crowded in there. There's a lot of us this year, so we also have, just outside of that space, if it's getting a little too much for you, there's a place called the On Air Club just outside the entrance to Studio B, which is sort of a little bar. It's where the ship does its karaoke and where we will have our nightly regular karaoke sessions as well. And that space is available to us as well. So you can, if you want to need something a little quieter and less filled with 1,000 people, you're welcome to go there as well. Yes?
If there's any chance that a guest becomes afraid or too overwhelmed and they don't feel safe, is there anywhere that they can find refuge or talk to somebody about how they're feeling?
I'd say go to the info desk outside of the game room and we'll be able to help.
And also, you're also welcome to speak to any of the ship's staff. They are also equipped and trained and prepared to deal. If you're not, the question was if anyone is at any point not feeling safe and needs to find a refuge or a place or someone to talk to about it. What's that? There's a psychologist.
And you see, also, with the helper monkey lanyards, you can approach any of them, and they've been trained.
I hadn't gotten through
trained to find help.
I hadn't gotten through all this many. So the cocktail at the cocktail reception 4:45, dinner 5:45, and then Jonathan Coulton and his band will perform at 9 o'clock in Studio B. And immediately following that show, approximately 10:30, we have what we call the Welcome Monkeys Mixer. Basically, just the bar remains open, and people are encouraged to mingle, and if you are interested in meeting new people, they are interested in meeting you.
Oh, it's not an open bar, but the bar remains.
Yeah, no, bar remains serving drinks. Any other questions at all? Over here. The question here is, there are several events at which we will be giving us all of our personal cash.
That is another typo. Yes.
question over here.
For live band karaoke, is it a
song? Oh. The question is regarding live band karaoke. Well, live band karaoke is a thing we've done in the past few years, which unfortunately are not doing this year, the live band karaoke.
I know.
We, part of the deal with being a smaller group on a ship is we have to battle for times that are available in venues. And because the schedule only had room for so much, we decided that it would serve more people to do the regular karaoke. So if you're talking about the karaoke on a big stage, that's a good question. The library is 25,000 plus songs and is available on Cruise Monkey. We didn't want to print a book of it because it would be about as tall as half of me. But it is available on Cruise Monkey. If you're not connected, find someone who has Cruise Monkey. But there'll be sign-up forms for that, and you just look through the schedule. We feel terrible and we feel bad that we don't have the live band area.
It'll be back, but we're not able to do this here.
I'm sorry, did you have an actual question over here?
Oh, poker tournament, yes. We did, at the last minute, we were able to work out with the casino manager. Basically, every night, possibly even including the last night, I wasn't clear about that, but every night, including tonight, at 7:30 in the casino, they're holding a sit-and-go poker event. It's a $50 buy-in with $30 rebuys, I believe. If you don't play poker, then none of this means anything to you. It's a four person minimum each night. If there are open seats at the point it starts, they'll open it up to other non-JoCo cruisers. But then you can sign up in the casino at the register, the cashier desk for that. That'll be every night at 7:30.
They were about to interrupt with their announcement for the muster station, so I think unless there are any other super pressing questions, I think we'll have to call that at the end.